Time ago, I spoke with a Bay Area doctor about a medical device surging in demand and some eyebrow-raising suggestions from the president. There's been a surge in demand for these pulse oximeters that measure your oxygen levels at home if you've been either exposed to COVID-19 or think you could have been exposed. How reliable are these devices, and how often should we be checking your oxygen levels?
So there's been a lot of talk in regards to pulse oximeters, and I just wanted to take this opportunity to clarify some questions for our viewers. Now, not everyone has to rush out there and get a pulse oximeter, but we do recommend that people who have underlying medical conditions, especially lung conditions, have one handy just to be able to check their pulse, pulse ox, as we call it, the level of oxygen in your blood, in case they're having symptoms or in case they're, you know, positive with COVID and staying at home and self-isolating. The thing that we need to remember is if you're young, if you're healthy, you don't need to run to the store and buy a pulse oximeter because, of course, that's going to create a shortage of those devices for the people that truly need it. So if you are in one of those populations, for example, older than 65, or you have underlying medical conditions, it would be something that I'd recommend that you keep at home, kind of like a thermometer, but instead this device is going to check your oxygen level for you and also check your pulse, which is your heart rate.
Now, Doctor, Lysol's parent company is warning against injecting disinfectants after President Trump asked whether it or UV lights could possibly be used as a COVID-19 treatment. This is just one of a lot of different kinds of information that is circulating out there. What are you telling your patients when it comes to this influx of not so great medical advice?
When you're to get medical advice for a medical condition, the one person that you should listen to is your doctor. There is absolutely no evidence behind any of these claims that you should be injecting or ingesting Lysol or any other cleaner for that matter in order to kill coronavirus. We don't need to do any studies on this. We know what happens. These are poisonous chemicals and they have very bad outcomes. So if you're listening, please stay away from these solvents other than to use them as guided and as instructed to clean your home with, and that's it. I just want to reiterate this again. If you need medical advice, please get it from a physician. That's the only person you should be listening to at this point.
The FDA also issued a warning against using the anti-malarial drug hydroxychloroquine to treat coronavirus, saying it can have dangerous side effects. What are some of those side effects, and is that something that you're very much concerned about?
It has been something I have been concerned about since the beginning. And the reason being, since the beginning, you know, I've had a lot of questions about this. Patients have been asking to get these medications just to keep on hand in case they get sick. And I've been very hesitant from the beginning to take these medications because, one, they do come with side effects. These are very strong medications. And two, we just don't know how people are going to react to it, especially with those that have underlying problems. Now, some of the side effects can include heart arrhythmias, and others that we've known to found with this medication category, like hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine, is that it can also increase your insulin. So you can have low blood sugar due to it. Now, we have no kind of evidence right now that these medications are remotely helpful when it comes to treating COVID. So what the FDA is recommending right now is that this medication be given, if at all, under physician supervision inside the hospital or just for the clinical trials that are ongoing. But I've always said this, and I continue to say this, there's no reason to take these medications if you're in the community and if you get your hands on them, because the side effects are very serious and some of them can even lead to death.